Hello, my name is Kevin Cavell, and I'm a product manager for Agilent Technologies, soon to be Keysight Technologies. Today I'm going to give you a demonstration of our N7900 advanced power system along with the 14585 control and analysis software. We're going to test an electronic vehicle as well as the battery that's powering that vehicle. So if we take a look at the electronic vehicle we have here today, you can see it's a very advanced EV. It's a lot easier to test than a real one, but we'll get the concepts from this that you can apply to much larger electronic vehicles, as well as many other devices. So our electronic vehicle is powered by this 6-volt battery. I've set the power supply up to be 6 volts, and we'll quickly power our device under test to see if things are running. I just have to turn the output on. We see we're getting 6.6 volts to our device, and if I power it here, you can see it's running. And if you can see the front panel, it's about 1.5 amps and about 10 watts. So we get an idea from the front panel, a rough idea of what the power consumption is. But if we want to take a closer look at the power consumption, we can use the 14585 software. The power supply, the N7900 has a built-in digitizer, and we can use the software to actually look at that data and what the waveform that the power, the motor is pulling from the power source looks like. So let's take a look at the software and what that waveform looks like now. Now we're taking a look at the 14585A software. There are 4 major modes of operation: the scope mode for short-term measurements, the data logger mode for long-term measurements, CCDF for statistical analysis, and arbitrary waveform. We can see that we're connected to the instrument by clicking on the instrument control, flyout window, and you see a front panel. We're in scope mode right now, and we're set up to capture the current drain from the motor of our electric vehicle. Everything's been set up so we capture that waveform. All I need to do is press play. There's 2 seconds of pre-trigger that are filling up. Once that's filled up, all I need to do is press the button on the electric vehicle to let it run. So I ran the electric vehicle 3 separate times, and we can see the waveform here. The first 2 times I ran, there was no stress to the motor. The wheels were off the ground. And then the 3rd time, I was stressing the motor by placing my foot up against the wheel to have some resistance. So you can see that the current draw for the first 2 is much lower than the 3rd when it's under stress. So that was very easy. All we need to do is a few clicks of the mouse to set this measurement up, and we have something that's just like an oscilloscope capturing the power consumption of our electric vehicle. The next step in this process is to place this waveform into our arbitrary waveform generator in the software. We'll manipulate this data, and we'll be able to use the power supply as an electronic load to test the battery by having the power supply pull this exact current from the battery, and it's just a few simple steps to do that. I've connected the 6-volt battery to the power supply. You'll notice that the output of the power supply is off, yet we're still showing about 6.5 volts. That's because the power supply is measuring the output of the battery. We'll now test the battery using the waveform we captured from the electronic vehicle. We'll now take the waveform and import it into our arbitrary waveform generator. It's very simple. We just have to go up to scope and then click on save trace to ARB. It's that simple to import a waveform into our arbitrary waveform generator. Then all we need to do is go to the ARB section of the software and set everything up to have a current waveform. We choose the output that we want, click add. There are 3 different ways to create waveforms. We're going to use the imported waveforms. Scroll down to the one we want. Here it is. It's the scope data from our capture. Now, this is positive current. And in order to test the battery, we'll want to be in our electronic load mode, which would be negative current, which would be pulled from the battery. So we just have to quickly modify this waveform by clicking on Modify, and very simply click on Mirror, and the waveform becomes negative at that point. We save our result, make sure that we've chosen that, and click Done. And that gets imported right into the output of the power supply. And we now can run that as an arbitrary waveform with our battery. And it's just like the motor of our electronic vehicle is pulling that current from the battery. So we're actually turning our power supply into an electronic vehicle emulator, so it can constantly pull that waveform from the battery without actually needing to have the electronic vehicle with us. We're now back in scope mode. I've set everything up so that we can properly capture the current being drawn from the battery. All we need to do is click play on the scope again. The pre-trigger is filling. We click play on the ARB, and now the waveform that we created is being pulled from the battery. And we can see that the data is being pulled down at this point. You can see the waveform on the screen. It's the exact same waveform that we captured from the electronic vehicle, but it's the inverse because it's being pulled from the battery. This is really a great feature because it's very simple to set up, but it's a very complex task to do without these instruments and this software. Another test you could do with this information is what's called a battery rundown test, where we run the waveform over and over again for about 1 hour to test how long the battery would last under these conditions. We can do this in our data logger mode, run this for about an hour. I did this already, so you can see the data on the screen. The voltage of the battery starts at about 6.6 volts, and then over time it runs down, and you can see the curve as we go out in time goes down to say about 5.5 volts. And this would give the user the ability to understand how long this battery would last under these conditions. Today I demonstrated how easy it is to capture the current waveform from an electronic vehicle using the 14585A software and an N7900 advanced power system. If you happen to have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comment section and we'll do our best to get back to you. Thanks for watching.